Yeah, I'm gonna keep this hand. It looks like a normal hand, but it's got a mere battle sphere in it. One of the reasons this deck is a one of the I guess disadvantages of playing this deck is every now and then you do have these hands where it just looks like a normal hand, and then you've got this random uncastable artifact. Though I suppose last game I did cast Mirror Battlesphere to good effect, so that's not entirely true. But yeah, this is a this is basically what the hand actually looks like. It's like, hey, wait, would you keep the six carder? You know, ask him, and then he's like, sure. And then all of a sudden, it's like, whoop, there goes the Battlesphere. All right, Tezzeret's good. Tezzeret's good. Negate kind of sucks. I mean, I know it's decent against Valakut too, but and like if you're gonna have a one of counter, I guess in the late game it's a little better than Mana Leak. But again, Mana Leaks are kind of at the top of my list to add to this deck. Ooh, Inquisition, I like that. Can't spell Pierce. He could Mana Leak it, which I would probably allow. All right, well I can't take much here, so I'm gonna go ahead and take the spell Pierce. Yeah, definitely would rather resolve a Planeswalker next turn, even though he plays Squadron Hawk. Of course, if this was a Mana Leak, I could Mana Leak the Hawk, but he's got some Wraths and a Seagram Coast. He's probably going to have drawn another Spell Pierce, since that's just how he rolls. Yep, Hawk resolves. I'm just going to play Jace and Brainstorm here, I think is the plan, and then next turn he can play his own Jace if he wants, but he can't kill mine with Squadron Hawk, at least not yet. So his hand is two Hawks, some Wraths, some lands. And there's a Forge Master, which is not too bad. Oh, he doesn't have the Spell Pierce? That's a first. Alright. Let's put the Battle Ball back. Because next turn I can Tezzeret plus one it and pick up Mirror Battlesphere if I want it. And if I don't want it, I can, you know, bin it. Here is probably going to play attack me for one and play a Jace, is what I would imagine. Though I guess he could play another pair of Hawks. Though that wouldn't really, after attacking Jace for one, though that wouldn't be too bad, because then I could plus two Jace, putting it out of range of him killing it, and play like a Forge Master. Which, because now that he has three Hawks in play, Wrath is not as good. Yeah, he makes the play I expected, which was to do that. Alright, so I take one, go to 19, and have to figure out what I want to do now. I believe the play here is going to be, since I'm drawing an island, dressing him, and then playing a Tezzeret and plus one it. That's going to put a fair amount of pressure on him. Alright, so land and duress. Alright, see a handful of Day Judgments and a Spell Pierce. That Spell Pierce looks like it'll be annoying at some point. Not too concerned about Dead Judgment. My plan here is to take Spell Pierce, play Tezzeret, plus one Tezzeret. Next turn he doesn't really have any play but to attack for one and maybe play some Hawks. He's waiting on me. So I'm gonna go ahead and take Spell Pierce, play the Tez Father, and plus one. Again, though he has two Dead Judgments and I have Forge Masters, I'm gonna try to get him with Tezzerets here, so really don't want him to be able to Spell Pierce. Normally I would just take Sphere of the Suns, but let's see. How's this game going to go? He's going to battle Tezzeret down to 3, possibly play some Hawks. Whether or not he draws a land also will determine things. Like, he's going to play a land next turn. I can't necessarily assume he's not going to draw a land the following turn to start activating Celestial Colonnades. So, but Mirror Battlesphere is pretty sweet. No, I'm just going to take Sphere of the Sun so I can play two things the following turn. And Shippe the Turno. I mean, tapping out for Battlespear seems fine, but he's, again, got two Wraths in his hand, so it's hard to imagine that he won't just Wrath. Taking Spell Pierce seemed good, just in case I wanted to cast something sweet here. Though, it's certainly possible I want to take Wrath, considering I'm going to play a Forge Master this turn. This coming turn, depending on what he plays here. Hopefully, yeah, okay, so it's just a Hawk. Alright. So he's got, his hand is two Wraths and two Hawks, plus whatever it is he drew for the turn. Which is, we're about to find out if he's preordaining or something here. No, it looks like just another Hawk. Alright. So Tezzeret's going to go up to 4, so he's not going to be able to kill Tezzeret quite yet, and I'm going to play a Forge Master. Another reason it takes Fearless Sons is so I can activate Forge Master. So it's plus one to Tez Father. Missed on Tezzeret. That doesn't happen too often, though. Kind of sucks. Alright. I'm just really unlucky, as you can no doubt see. And if I get to untap with Forge Master, that's usually pretty sweet. It would have been nice to hit on Tezzeret there so I could play two artifacts next turn, but I already have one, so if I draw the second one, then I'm good to go. And he can't even kill Tezzeret unless he has a land, in which case I again get to untap with Forge Master. And then next turn, I could, if he goes land, activate Celestial Colonnade, kill Tezzeret, I can untap, replay Tezzeret, plus one, and then leave Negate up for his Day of Judgment if that's what he chooses to cast. Alternately, he can attack Tezzeret down to one, then Day of Judgment here, which kills all his Hawks, and then he plays a Hawk post-combat. Though if he's a land, I would not be surprised if he just killed Tezzeret with Celestial Colonnade and, I guess, got me for three. We'll see what he does shortly. Alright, it looks like he's playing land, and his plan is probably to Day of Judgment post-combat here, since if he's not killing Tezzeret with Colonnade, there's really no other option for him, since untapping with Forge Master usually works out pretty well. And even though I missed on Artifact, he knows I've got a Sphere of the Suns, so he knows I've got at least one. Let's see. Kaboom. Yep. And might as well play that last Hawk. So he's got a Day of Judgment and a Mystery card. Alright, let's plus one Tezzeret again and find something sweet. Alright, Forge Master. Oh, ooh, Tumble Magnet. That is actually very sweet. Tolmanet is so good in this matchup. Tolmanet is actually just really good in general. It's actually one of the reasons that I think this deck is actually good. It's the best quality about this deck really is Tumble Magnet. It's just very good right now. It stops a lot of what most of the decks are doing and protects Planeswalkers very, very well. So here he can't even kill Tezzeret. He can just keep activating Colonnades, but that doesn't really get him anywhere. I'm Tezzeretting every turn, and which is canceling the Hawk out. Alright. Looks like we'll go ahead and Tumble Magnet the Colonnade. He may or may not Tech Edge here, but since we have so many lands, it probably doesn't really make that much sense. So now we're in a quote stalemate where I get to Tezzeret every turn. Ooh, Mindslaver. That's kind of nice. Let's see what we've got here. A Sphere of the Suns. Alright. He can't Spell Pierce or anything, so resolving Mindslaver seems good. And I definitely would rather just leave Negate up instead of casting Sphere of the Suns here, since there's no real reason to. I think he's going to be using his Tech Edges now. He can burn another. If he wants to burn a counter on Tumble Magnet, he gets double Tech Edge, so he's probably not going to do that. I mean, even if he Tech Edges both my lands, next turn I still get to burn his Wrath and Squadron Hawk, plus possibly screw with whatever he drew. Let's see what he's got. A Gideon? Oh, another. He is activating the Colonnade. All right. And we will Tumble Magnet it, and he's going to go ahead and Tech Edge our... No, he's not Tech Edging. Interesting. Possibly he's got a land, so he can Tech Edge his own Tech Edge. Or Tech Edge one of our lands, I guess. Or nothing. I guess he's just resigned to his fate. Alright, well. So we are gonna Mindslaver. And we're probably going to want to use his Day of Judgment, so I guess we could double Tech Edge him down to three lands, and then negate Day of Judgment. I'm debating whether or not I want to... So you could play Tezzeret. Because I can actually play two Tezzerets this turn. Like a minus one Tezzeret on a Sphere, minus one Tezzeret on Tumble Magnet. That actually seems like the play. That just kills him. So, minus one Tezzeret. And minus one Tezzeret. And then Mindslaver him. So, alright, that was... Seems like a good solution to how to win this game. Boom. 10, and yeah, he had a Gideon last turn, but it doesn't actually do anything, so now I could double tech edge him, but I just tap him out and attack for one and kill him. So there goes the first match.